कंस चानोरमर्दनम देवकी परमानंदम कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं त्वमेव माता च पितात्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुस्य सखात्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविडं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देव। हरि ओम। वी आर नाउ डूइंग द स्टार्टिंग द 15th चैप्टर ऑफ पंचदशी। पंचदशी मीन्स 15, सो दिस इज द 15th chapter, which is the last chapter of Panchadasi. So the Panchadasi is set up in terms of three major sections. The first section of first five chapters deals with the sat aspect of the Brahman, that means the existence aspect, and the next five chapters, that is from the 6 to 10, it deals with the chit aspect or Deepa Prakaranam. Deepa means light that illumines everything in the whole universe, because of which I am conscious of. And the last five chapters, starting from the 10th to this 15th chapter, deals with the Ananda. So Sat Chit Ananda aspects are being discussed, and this last five chapters are also considered as a separate book, also as a Brahmananda. So this the 15th chapter is entitled Brahmanande Vishayanandaha. Previous chapter Brahmanande Vijayanandaha, where the Vijaya is about the highest knowledge, or that is the real knowledge. Everything else is not really real, but only for transactionally real, or at the level of pure Brahman, it is false knowledge, but at the relative level, it's a relative knowledge needed for relative transactions. That includes every knowledge that you can think of. If you go to Google and ask what is knowledge, they will only define the relative knowledge, because it says knowledge of. Knowledge of means anything that is qualified is relative only. That which is real knowledge of Brahman cannot be qualified, because Brahman being infinite. So for separating all other knowledge with respect to Brahman, it can be said Vedanta is a knowledge, but it tries to point out in the direction for one to think, because it cannot really say anything about Brahman. Yato vacho nivartante apraapya manasa saha. Even the speech cannot reach there, or the mind cannot reach there. Na vagacchati na manaha. So neither the speech or the we cannot communicate about it. So then how the whole Vedanta says, the bhashyas and all that pages and pages of literature on something that you cannot describe. So it is in the direction trying to point out from where you are. Therefore there are many depending upon the qualifications of students. Now we are talking about the same Ananda from the point of a normal person who doesn't have no interest on this. So how do we come to his level to teach about the Brahmananda? So here is the chapter that discusses about the Vishayananda is Brahmananda. That means even the experience or the happiness that one gets in the world outside through any means, because everybody is looking for happiness. That's the problem. Every jiva, every life form is looking for happiness. If you put a tree, the science experiments, we see that if you put a plant outside, it wants to turn in the direction where there is a sunlight, because that's the only way it will be happy. It needs a sunlight. So we are all looking for happiness, and we say, I need this, I need this, I need this. And our needs are so much that we struggle hard all the time to fulfill our needs. Why do we need that? With that I am going to be happy. If it doesn't bring happiness to me, then I don't need it. So it's called upeksha, that we discussed in the 13th chapter, where it says you don't care for it. Why? Just like the grass on the street, as you are walking by, what kind of, do you love the grass or you don't? Unless you are growing the grass in your yard, the street grass on the way, say you have no likes and dislikes, you ignore it, presence of it. And you ignore so many things when you are walking, there are so many people walking around and there are thousands and thousands of people walking. You do not bother about who are they, why are they, what are, where are they born, what are their names. You just because it's not concerned to you. That means upeksha. See, in either you love them nor you hate them. Unless they bother you or they help you to do something, then you have a reciprocal a likeness about them. So most of us, we only gather what we think is important, and we go after, starting the morning coffee, we go after for happiness, because first thing in the morning is good hot cup of coffee, then only I am happy. So what I am looking for is happiness, and I think a good hot cup of coffee gives happiness. So I am longing, or if I don't have coffee, I make coffee, I make an effort, all that process just to become happy. Now you have a cup of coffee, are you eternally happy? No, I need something else now. So longing for object goes on and on and on. So here Vishayanande is going to be talked about. He says whatever happiness that one gets, this is for everybody now, whatever happiness that one gets is not by the object per se. You are going after an object because it's, you think there is happiness there, but there is no happiness in any object. Happiness comes from pure Satchidananda only, from Brahman only. A part of it, a glimpse of it is being shown, and you are going for those glimpses of those, and you think the object is bringing. Whenever the desire is fulfilled, you are happy in that moments, and that moments of happiness is coming from Brahmananda only. So you are going after Brahmananda in a roundabout way. That's the whole process. If I understand it, then you can get that, a more efficient way of getting that same happiness or even more, because without any effort you can get. For getting happiness via coffee, you have to make an effort, you have to buy milk, you have to buy coffee powder, all that process you have to struggle hard in order to make, or go to restaurant to drink coffee. All that is struggled to get it, and struggled to maintain it, and struggled to when you lose it also. Somebody takes your coffee before you drink, then you get angry also. So all that is Vishayananda problem. That's what is going to be discussed here. So this chapter, from the practical point, you are looking for happiness in the wrong way, in a sense. And that's how the Brahmanande Vishayananda, because Ananda that you are looking for is not there in the objects. Okay, let's read the first sloka.
Atatra Vishayanandaha Brahmanandam Sarupabhak Nirupyate Dwarabhutaham Tadamsatvam Sutir Jagau Tadamsatvam Sutir Jagau. Together. Atatra Vishayanandaha Brahmanandam Sarupabhak Nirupyate Dwarabhutaha Tadamsatvam Sutir Jagau. So Sutihi Jagau, Sutihi is, scripture says this. What does it say? Ataha, now, Atra, in this chapter, Brahmananda Amsarupabhak. So an aspect of the bliss of Brahmananda, Amsham only, is only part of it. Remember in the Anandavalli we discussed this, that the Manushya Anandaha, that Gandharva, Manushya Gandharva Anandaha, Gandharva Deva Anandaha, and so on and so forth, all the way up to Brihaspati, and above that is Brahmaji. His Brahmaji is the maximum happiness that you can get in the hierarchy of the scale, and beyond that is only Brahman. And Brahmananda is only part of it, is coming through Brahmaji, because Brahmananda is infinite, and there is a millions of these of the creations, and there is a Brahmaji for each creation. So the Brahmaji Ananda is only part of it, and that Brahmaji is only 10 to the power of 26 times more of this
and therefore Manushya Ananda is very small part compared to Brahmaji Ananda. And this Manushya Ananda, the real human being that gets in the on downtown, is much much smaller, because we are talking about Manushya Ananda in the Upanishad. Talks about an emperor who has everything. His Ananda is only one unit. Now we have 0.0009 or 0009 of Ananda in the real, that one real human being, a normal human being, experiences. So therefore, only a part of it that you experience in life. So that is what, therefore, atha atra, in this chapter, Vishayanandaha Brahmanandam Sarupabhag. So it is only amsha, only a very small component of the Brahmananda only you can get in this Vishayananda, by fulfilling the desires of an object. And Dwarabhut, De Nirupyate Dwarabhutaha. So we are going to show that this is an entrance to find out what exactly is the real Brahmananda. So the Vishayananda helps you to inquire further into what exactly, why, how does, that's exactly what the scripture talks about. Pariksha lokan karmachidan brahmano nirvedamayan nascha krutakrutena tad vijnanartham sa guru meva abhigacche samitpanihi sotriyam brahmanishtam. Only after examining, so examination is required. Pariksha, pariksha lokan karmachidan brahmana, the one who is trying to get happiness by sense enjoyment, that is essentially the Vishayananda. So he has recognized at least that you are not going to get infinite happiness by finite pursuits. That's essentially what it means. So pariksha lokan karmachitan brahmano nirvedamanyascha krutakrutena, by any action one cannot get that infinite result. That is Brahmananda. So what are you, why are you doing this? Because I hope to get something as a result of my action. Why do you want that one? That will give me happiness. So what I am looking for in any action is only happiness. But happiness that I am looking for in all my pursuits is only temporarily, number one. I had to struggle hard to get it, and I had to struggle hard to preserve it, and I had to struggle hard, I feel bad when I lose it. Whereas that Brahmananda we are talking about, you don't have to struggle hard because you are already that. You are not going to maintain it, because that's a very substratum for that. And you are not going to lose it because you are that. So therefore, that is readily available, everybody is available, not everybody, every time available and all the time available, and yet we are turning our attention to somewhere else. That's what our problem is, due to ignorance. So this is the dwaram, the entrance to find out what is Brahmananda. This is the introductory sloka, number 2, sloka 2. एषोस्य परमानन्दः एषोस्य परमानन्दः यो खण्डैक रसात्मकः यो खण्डैक रसात्मकः अन्यानि भूतान्येतस्य मात्रामेवोपभुञ्जते मात्रामेवोपभुञ्जते. Together, Eshasya Paramanandaha Yo Khandaika Rasatmakaha Anyani Bhutanyetasya Matra Me Vopa Bhunjati. So Yaha, yes, is whoever. So Yo Kaha Akhandaika Rasatmakaha Yeshaha Asya Paramanandaha Yaha Akhandaika Rasatmakaha. So Yaha means that self, akhanda eka rasatmaka, it is of the nature of unbroken, that means unpartitioned or unparted, or you cannot break into pieces because it's infinite. So infinite cannot be parted. So that which is homogeneous, continuous, eternally present, that is of the nature of Satchidananda. It is its nature itself, and it is infinite. Being infinite, you cannot break it. So this is where the Advaita Vedanta differs from the other Vedanta, Visishtadvaita and Dvaita. Why? Because even in Visishtadvaita, where they accept that Brahman is the material cause, because Dvaita doesn't accept that, so we are not interested in Dvaita, because it says, Yathova imani bhutani jayante, ena jatani jivanti, yat prayam tabisham vishanti. So from which the whole universe came, by which it is sustained. With a sustenance means that it is adhara, adhishtanam. So without it, it cannot be. So the ring is sustained by the gold, bangle is sustained by the gold, and necklace is sustained by the gold. So from the gold, all the ornaments came, by which it is sustained, into which it goes back. So that is only the material cause. It won't go back into the goldsmith. Goldsmith is only nimitta karanam, efficient cause or intelligent cause, but the material cause is why Vedanta talks about. So in all other religions, God is defined as Jagatkarta Ishwaraha. God is the creator of the universe. That's what every religion say. So where is the God? You put him in heaven somewhere, because he wants to hide from everybody, otherwise they will start banging him. So say, how did he create? Where did he get material to create? In the other religions, you cannot ask that. So in Vedanta says that we cannot get a material separate from God, because then we'll ask who created that material. So material also has to come from him. Atornana bisujate grunnate cha, just as the spider creates the net. How does it create? Where does he get material? He doesn't go shopping and get a netting material. It creates material, has to come itself, and sometimes it withdraws also. So both the material and the intelligent cause is spider only. That's by the scripture test. So material also, the universe is nothing but the Lord himself appearing in many. So Brahman is appearing in many. In that appearance, it is only appearance but not really, because there cannot be real modification of the infinite. So these are all part of the philosophical discussions, where only in Advaita Vedanta it says this is only apparent creation, not a real creation. Whereas other people feel that this is a real creation, because the creation, because you see it, therefore it's real. And Vedanta Advaita says you see it, therefore it's not real. It's not unreal also, that's why they call it a mithya. And since they don't accept, other religions don't accept mithya, either you say real or it should be unreal, you cannot have in between. So it's not in between. Mithya is neither real nor unreal. It's not in between, half real, half unreal. It is neither real nor unreal. So it's not unreal means it's real enough for me to experience, but if you inquire it, it's not really there. So that's what essentially Maya means. And why I'm saying all that? Because in the pure consciousness, there cannot be any creation. Infinite cannot undergo any creation. So therefore, the akhandam, it is unbroken infiniteness. You cannot break into some conscious entities and unconscious entities. There is a chit, achit, and so on. That's how the Visishtadvaita talks about in the creation has three parts, two parts. One is chit and another is achit. And in chit part, again, there are two parts. One is Paramatma, another is Jivatma. So they are parting the infinite, Brahman. But you cannot be parted, because it says akhandam. Akhanda ekarasatmakam. One rasam. That means one constant, homogeneous, undifferentiated aspect. What do you call it? Is it Satta or is it Chitta or is Ananda? They are not three different things. Satta eva chit, chitta yahyaham. Is it that? Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi says. It's an existent consciousness which is limitless. Which is limitless means that is Ananda. So it is Sat Chit Ananda. So scripture defines that consciousness alone is infinite. So prajnanam brahma. Consciousness is infinite. So I had to I cannot differentiate the conscious part, unconscious part separately, because everything is only conscious. Akhanda ekarasatmakam. So that consciousness is infinite, therefore it is limitless, therefore it is ananda. Ananda is not, it have happiness, it is happiness itself. It is a swarupa lakshanam. Its intrinsic nature is happiness. There is no dukkham at all. There cannot be superimposed dukkham. It is homogeneous. That's why I call akhanda ekarasatmakam. So it is unbroken, homogeneous. You call either call it consciousness, either call it existence, or call it ananda. It's all one and the same. And that self is eshaha, that is the self, asya, of the self, paramanandaha. It is of the nature of supreme happiness. In the relative sense, we are talking about supreme is a comparison, because any other happiness is only relative, only its glimpse of that is coming up. But actually, that is the pure happiness, is only that. There is no happiness anywhere else. And that is paramanandaha. Anyani bhutani, all other beings, ekasya, as this one self alone, and matram, as a part of it, upabhunjati, they enjoy the happiness eva. So all other jivas are enjoying only a part, a minute part of this happiness. They are all going, they like a rat race, going for what? To get a glimpse of this happiness only. Akhanda ekarasatmakam. So it is any ananda is only glimpse of that. That is the essential message of that. Take sloka 3. Shanta ghorastada mooda. Shanta ghorastada mooda. Manaso ruttayastridha. मनसो वृत्तयस्त्रिधा वैराग्यं शान्तरौदार्यं वैराग्यं शान्तिरौदार्यं इत्याज्याः शान्तवृत्तयः इत्याज्याः शान्तवृत्तयः शान्ता घोरास्तदा मूढा मनसो वृत्तयस्त्रिधा वैराग्यं शान्तिरौदार्यं इच्छाज्याः शान्तवृत्तयः. सो शान्ता, सो हि नौ वी आर गोइंग इन टू मोर डिटेल्स एट दि माइंड लेवल. सो वाय हू इज अ जीवा. जीवा हैज ऑब्वियसली अंतःकरणम, ए सटल बॉडी इज देयर, दैट मेक्स अ जीवा एज एन इंडिविजुअल. वेयर इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द सिंपल इनर्ट वेयर देयर इज नो माइंड. सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ the chit achit in the creation, you can think of two. One is chit, another is chit. That's exactly the even the Vishishta Advaita emphasizes, but they take it as a real, we take it as only a transactionally real. That's all the difference is. So in the case of what makes a life, living beings are different from non-living beings. That's a simple statement. Living beings are different from non-living beings. And what are the living beings? That which have to have the asti, jayate, vruddhate, pranamate, vinasyati. There are six grids of modifications that undergo. Asti, jayate, it is, and it is born, and it grows and becomes old age and ultimately dies. So these are the six modifications of the life form. In the inert things, it is, that is the end of it. There is no evolution of the inert, because it will not have any modifications as such. And akasha will remain akasha. So here we are talking about the living beings versus non-living beings. What's the difference between in relation to the Brahman? What's the relation between the living beings and the non-living beings? And the non-living beings, they exist. Because we are not talking about non-existent, non-living beings. The word stone is, river is, mountain is, earth is, galaxies are, all these are, is, and all that. Whenever we say, that means it exists. So the existence is being expressed in the form. Earth is different from Mars, Mars is different from, so all other attributes belong to a particular one, but everyone has existence. Because for me to say it exists, that it has to exist. So existence itself is expressed in varieties and names and forms. Each name and form is different. The gold exists. That existence of the gold is now expressed in terms of ring form and a bangle form and a necklace form. Each has its own attribute, one different from the other. Ring is not same as a bangle, bangle is the same, not necklace. But all exist. And in all of them, there is a gold that pervades them, that sustains them, and they go back into them. That is the existence, is a material cause for the inert things. So all in the inert things, existence is expressed. In the living things, not only existence, but consciousness is also expressed. Consciousness exists because of the reflection of the consciousness in the equipments. In the inert things only the existence gets reflected. In the subtle material, both the existence and consciousness get reflected. That's called the chit and the sat aspects. And if the mind, that's called the mind, subtle body, which is essentially antakaranam, both the mind is. At the same time, mind by reflection has become a conscious entity, apparent conscious entity, just as by reflection of the sunlight, moon has become an apparent luminous entity. There is no luminosity in the moon by itself, it's only reflecting. So same way, the reflecting mind is only reflecting the pure Satchidananda that is getting reflected, and the process of reflection, it is acting as though it's a conscious entity. So that's the difference between the living versus non-living. Only the reflecting medium is subtle enough to reflect even the chitta aspect. And further, if the mind has become calm and serene, and that's called modification of the mind into a calm state, and that when even the ananda also gets reflected. And that is now being discussed in terms of vritti. Vritti means modification of the mind. So here the modification of the mind is being discussed in terms of thought process. So texture of the thought or the quality of the thought is being discussed in terms of whether the Satchidananda gets reflected or only Chit and Sat get reflected, and so on. So here we classify the thought process into three gunas, because they belong to a prakriti: sattva guna, rajo guna, and tamo guna. And these are going to be talked about in terms of three gunas. Now we are talking about the sattva guna thoughts and rajo guna thoughts and tamo guna thoughts, and these are called shanta, ghora, stada, mudha. So shanta is sattva guna, and ghora is rajo guna, and mudha is called tamo guna. These are the three, tada, manasaha, vrittaya, stridha. The mind has three types of thoughts. This is for across the board. For all human beings who can think, they have three types of thoughts. One is sattva guna pradhana, another is rajo guna pradhana, and third is the tamo guna pradhana. So shanta gorastada muda manaso vrittaya stridha. So manasaha vrittaya, the quality of the mind is three types. And here to talk about what is shanta guna: vairagyam shanti raudaryam ichyajya shanta vrittaya. So iti adaha, etc., etc. What are they? Vairagyam. Vairagyam means dispassion. Dispassion means I like this, I have I need this, I hatred and likes and dislikes. Those are the not there. So it becomes the upeksha. Things come, it's okay. Things don't come also, it's okay. My mind is calm and serene irrespective of what type things are occurring. That's called vairagyam. And shanti, Shanti is essentially the forbearance here, whatever that is essentially, Vairagyam and Shanti, forgiveness here, and Audaryam. Audaryam means and large heartedness. So forgiveness of some people committing anything towards you, you have become Shanti, says peaceful, irrespective of what they do. So that calls also the forgiveness or also forbearance also involved. And Audaryam, large heartedness, that means you are ready to excuse everybody because they all do not know the true nature. So any commitment or anything is misbehavior is only because of ignorance only. So Audaryam comes into picture when it is needed. That's what you're very careful. Ichyadhyaha are called Shantavrittayaha. These are the qualities of the Sattva Guna. So we're going to more details of this in the next stop. We'll stop here.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.